This is how to make these smooth trending Apple text animations in Premiere Pro. Start by adding the transform effect to the text layer and then make sure you're at the start of the clip. Now click on the stopwatch next to position and opacity to create keyframes and then move these keyframes forward a bit. Now move the text down using the position values and then set the opacity to 0%. And this will slowly fade and animate the text up. If the animation is too slow, then you can move the keyframes closer to the left. And to give the animation the Apple feel, you need to select all the keyframes, right-click temporal interpolation ease in and then select ease out. And then you also need to tweak the speed of the animation a bit. So expand the arrow next to opacity and position and then click on one keyframe to show these blue handles. And then you can drag the right handle a bit to the left, so that the animation goes fast in the beginning and then gradually slows down. But don't move it up or down, since that will mess up the animation. And do this with both graphs. Now a pro tip to make it look even better is to move the first opacity keyframe forward just a few frames, so that the text fades in a bit later than the animation. And you have to play around with this to make it look right. And if you align the player with the first position keyframe, then you can also tweak the position value further if you don't like it. Also, don't forget to increase the shutter angle to 360 to enable motion blur, and I will show you how to animate each word in a second. But first we need to create the out animation, so move to a point where you want to animate it out and then create keyframes for position and opacity, then move forward a bit again and then move the text up using the position values. And you can of course also choose any other direction that you want and then set the opacity down to 0. And then you also need to ease the keyframes again. For the out animation, you can use the same graph as for the start animation. And to make the out animation even smoother, you can use the same trick that I showed you earlier with the opacity keyframe. But this time, move the last opacity keyframe back a bit, so that the text fades out before the animation is complete. And as long as your player is aligned with any keyframe, you can adjust the value without creating a new one. Now to animate each word separately, you need to apply the crop effect to the text layer and then click on the crop effect in effects controls. Now use these handles to crop out the other words, so only one is visible. Then duplicate the text layer by holding Alt or Option on Mac and then drag it up one track. Then select the crop effect again, isolate the second word and do the same thing with the third layer. Once done correctly, we should have one word on each layer. Now to animate each word in the right order, we need to offset each layer a bit. So move to the start of the clip and then hold shift and press the right arrow key to move forward 5 frames. And then align the second layer to the player. Then move forward 5 frames again and do the same with the third layer. And we now got the first part of the Apple text animation. Now if you want to use the same effect on a different line of text, then you need to duplicate the layer, remove the crop effect and then change all the words. Then apply the crop effect again, isolate each word on a separate layer, and then simply offset each layer by 5 frames. And now we have this nice slide up Apple text animation. To create this Apple sliding right animation, you do the same steps as earlier. But instead of moving the text down, you move it to the right. And for the position graph, you want to drag it all the way to the left, and the left handle up a bit. You create keyframes, move forward, and then you move the text to the left, and ease the keyframes. For the out animation, you create the same graph as the in animation, but reversed. So drag the position graph all the way to the right and the right handle up as well. And move the opacity keyframe back a bit. And then isolate each word and offset them.
And also make sure that the transform effect is above the crop effect, otherwise the animation will look really weird.
This is the Apple text animation that we have created. And if you don't want to do all this tedious work, then I actually have a smooth text animation template linked in the description below that literally does all the work for you. Just type in your own text, customize the design, and then change the position offset, and then you're done. You can literally create Apple text animations in less than 30 seconds. And you can adjust the position offset to animate it from whatever direction you want. And you also have other features like text blur and extra smooth motion blur. So if you want to create Apple text animations in seconds without any time consuming work, then check out the template linked in the description below.